I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Today is Friday, September 2017th. I'm not sure what today is. I'm Russ Wiles, here with Marissa Petronella, and it's once again set up for KTV Live Intergalactic.
So, Ross, today for KTV we have to wear jerseys.
Yeah, I got my Joe Klecko Jets jersey and my my Jets hat.
And I have my cheer jersey on, so let's get into the news.
Recently, a few weeks ago, Congress decided to refund the government for at least a few months. This decision came just 3 weeks after the government reportedly shut down. It says lawmakers will successfully deal with shorter-term budget decisions. Republicans want to lessen the cuts for defense, while Democrats want to hire 2014 funding cuts. These disagreements funding the government for 2014. If Congress fails to compromise, by January 15th, another government shutdown will occur.
Today's KTV holiday is National Bus Safety Week. This whole week is for you to really understand what bus safety is. NCBusSafety.org stated that bus safety is knowing what to do if your bus gets in an accident. Examples would be if your bus tips over or you get out of it by using the passageway on the top. Also this week means when you're walking to the bus, always remember to walk, not run. The bus stop isn't going anywhere. Also stay on the sidewalk. www.safekids.org said that always introduce people to hold the railing when entering the bus, exiting the bus. Most injuries are from tripping down the stairs.
Speech students, today is Ms. Gobley's speech day, so remember to go to speech today during your cycle class.
It is still in debate whether or not the killer of whales in the killer whale in SeaWorld will be released or not. Experts say they are against keeping the animals in captivity. Even though the animals put on a stellar show, it should be in the best interest of them.
Ross, I'm here with the sports.
Yet again, you were here with sports, and I'm so excited.
I'm always here with the sports.
Always.
All right, so the Cardinals beat the Red Sox yesterday, 4-2.
Really good.
Close game, World Series, started off. All right, also the Panthers beat the Buccaneers, 31-13.
Yeah, that was great. That was a great game. Cam Newton went off yesterday.
Yeah, I heard. All right, and in college football, Kentucky beat Mississippi State. Actually, no. Mississippi State beat Kentucky 28-22.
Go Mississippi State.
And tonight the Sharks and the Bruins will play, so I'll tune in.
Yeah, it's going to be a really good game.
Yeah. So let's get back into the news.
Let's get back into it.
All NHJS members, make sure you are coming up with your service project ideas and who you will be in group with. Recently, a winning lottery Jersey Cash 5 ticket was sold at the Clark ShopRite, the New Jersey Lottery announced. About how much was this lottery ticket worth? A, $200,000, B, $1 million, C, $100, or D, $1,050. And the answer is D, $150,000. This ticket correctly matched all five numbers drawn in the Jersey Cash 5. According to the Clark Patch, the ShopRite will receive a bonus check of $2,000 for holding the winning ticket. Two more winning Jersey Cash 5 tickets were sold in East Brunswick and Manville.
Recently, CNN.com reported that a certain dog treat are making dogs sick. The treat Jersey Treats are causing diarrhea, sluggishness, and other sicknesses. The website also says that death can be caused.
So, Ross, we have a flyer over there with Leah and Gennato.
So let's pass it over to them.
So, Leah, it looks like there's a Halloween bike ride and trunk or treat on Sunday at Oak Ridge Park.
Wow, that's really cool. You all should go.
If you want to sign up, it's from 3 to 5 p.m., and it's $5 per child and $10 per adult. So, back to you guys in the studio.
So, that sounds really interesting. I'm definitely going to sign up.
So am I.
So, let's get back into the news.
Halloween is coming up very soon, and George got to ask students what their biggest fear was. So let's pass it over to George.
Thank you, guys. Well, women are typically more afraid of spiders than men. Let's take a look at what some of our fellow classmates are scared of. Halloween is right around the corner, and Halloween always brings creepy and frightening thoughts and items. What is your biggest fear?
My biggest fear are spiders because they creep me out.
My biggest fear is the dark because I don't know what's coming.
My biggest fear is being burned alive because it's very painful.
My biggest fear is heights because if I fall from a high distance, I'll die.
My biggest fear is roller coasters because they're scary.
My biggest fear is spiders because they're really creepy.
My biggest fear is when my sister scares me in the middle of the night because I don't know when it's coming.
My biggest fear is Taylor O'Connor because she scares me.
My biggest fear is having monsters under my bed because when I'm asleep, I feel like they're just going to come up and kill me.
My biggest fear is witches because they could take me off on their flying broomstick and boil me in a pot of water, and then I'll die.
According to theriches.com, the most common fear is misophobia, which is believing that you're always contaminated with germs.
Today's KTV birthday is Katy Perry. Today, Katy Perry is known for her topping songs Teenage Dream, Firework, and Roar. According to famousbirthdays.com, in 2008, her song I Kissed a Girl, and in 2012, her song was voted Woman of the Year by Billboard in 2012. Also, Perry wrote songs for Selena Gomez and Ashley Tisdale. While in 2012, Katy Perry's hit song is Teenage Dream. Today, Katy Perry will be turning 29.
So, Jeff, you are here with the weather, I heard.
I am here with the weather, as a matter of fact.
So, tell me.
Let's do it. Okay. Today will be a high of 54.
Pretty good.
And also, it'll be a high of 57 Saturday.
Is it supposed to rain on Saturday?
I believe not. No, the sun will be hiding behind the clouds.
That's good.
Well, it'll be good. Also, it'll be 57, a high 57 on Sunday.
Nice.
Sunny.
Nice.
A little chilly, though.
I have a soccer game, so that'll be good.
I have a football game. And on Monday, it'll be sunny with a high of 59.
That is fantastic.
It is fantastic.
At least it's not like it is right now. It's so cold.
All right, so see you later, Ross.
Thanks.
Honors Math will be learning a ton of new things this year, and this month their lesson is based around slopes, lines on graphs.
We are learning linear equations. Linear equations basically are lines and how to find the slope of the line. It is one of the key concepts in algebra, so this is an essential concept that the students need to know of how to find the slope, how to graph a slope, and how to find the slope.
Actually, slope, also known as gradient of a line, is a number that describes both direction and the steepness of the line. The formula you need to do is rise over run. You just need to see where your line goes perfectly on the y and x axis. If you go up or right on in your slope, it's positive. If it goes down or left, it's negative. According to Ms. Hull, linear equations and slope are extremely important, and it is crucial that these classes master this skill.
If you are in regular math classes and would like to join honors, speak to your counselor about what you need to do.
Recently, Apple released a new iPad, the iPad Air. This new iPad is much lighter than the previous. Apple.com said that the new iPad is 28% lighter, only being 1 pound. The website also said that another new improvement is the new Retina display.
So, Ross, we have to go over with Mackenzie and Danielle. So let's
pass it over
to
them.
So, Mackenzie, I hear we have a great show on Monday.
You know, I've been hearing that too.
I know, I'm pretty excited. We have a quiz on some UFOs.
That's great. And I hear we have an interview with the alien that came from the UFO.
Yeah, I personally got to ask it some questions.
Ooh, well, that's pretty cool.
Yeah, I know.
I can't wait to watch. It's been a great jam-packed Friday.
And Greg says that Monday is going to be a jam-packed Monday show. So back to you guys in the studio.
So I'm excited for Monday's show.
Yeah, everyone should definitely tune in for that show.
Yeah.
So for even more K2 News, don't forget to subscribe to us on Facebook, Twitter, or YouTube. For Marissa Petronella and the rest of the K2 News team, I'm Ross Wilds. Have an amazing day.
Please come.